a word about fuels, right? So when you talked about fuels and burning them, you might begin to have a question as to why burning fuels like coal and petroleum was considered to be polluting to the environment. And also, why are they called fossil fuels? Right? Fossils are a very, very weird word to associate with fuels, right? Now, the first thing is that these coal and petroleum, these compounds contain nitrogen and sulfur usually. And when you burn them, along with the energy and carbon dioxide and water that's released, which are, you know, per se not too harmful, even though carbon dioxide is a greenhouse gas, these sulfur and nitrogen get oxidized to give you oxides of sulfur and oxides of nitrogen, which both of which are pretty harmful and they are pollutants. So that's one of the reasons why we're a little worried about burning fossil fuels to give us our source of energy. Then, why are these called fossil fuels? For years and years and years, plant matter, right? Yeah, or animal matter, organic matter as we call it, right? To do with life. As it gets compressed by the pressures. So once it gets buried, there's layer after layer after layer of crust that's forming on top of it, right? Sediments. And so there's more, larger and larger and larger pressure on it, and it gets compressed to form what we call coal or petroleum. So in other words, it's fossilized animal and plant remains, fossils, which is why they're called fossil fuels. Now, it also gives us a chance to bust a myth that's been taught very, very commonly in schools. I don't know if it is taught here as well, which is when coal undergoes an extremely large amount of pressure, it begins to give you diamonds. And that supposedly is the way in which diamonds are formed. But the truth is, every single diamond you see has its origin even before life ever formed. So coal is by compressing organic matter or life. But the origin of diamonds is much before that. So diamonds and coal aren't really, you can't really compress coal and ever get diamond. Yeah, it's just not happening that way. There are certain conditions of temperature and pressure under which carbon atoms can come together to form these crystallized structures, octahedral crystals that somehow have a huge value in our society called diamonds.
To keep learning with such engaging videos, download BYJU’S, the learning app, today.